Good afternoon and welcome to Royal Caribbean's Pyramid Lounge and the 5th annual KMC Cruise Show. My name is Kenny Martell. Almost 40 years ago, I had the most unbelievable opportunity of a lifetime, creating an experiment combining several diverse forms of entertainment spanning from theater to Las Vegas, from concert to nightclub and cabaret, into a single band, or as I prefer to call it, a cast. I didn't want to limit the music to only rock or pop or country, rhythm and blues, Broadway show tunes, or whatever. The result was a cast of performers not restricted by labels of what could or could not be done. It was an instant success with the press and in the public eye. I didn't know what to call it except to say it was a new concept. The press dubbed it the Kenny Martell concept, and the name stuck. In subsequent years, several hundred of the most incredibly talented people I believe to be on the face of this earth passed through the various KMC casts. I am so proud of each and every one of them. All the entertainers you're about to see have played an integral role in the KMC. I hope you enjoy.
Live from Television City, it's Sonny and Cher.
The beat goes on, the beat goes on. Drums keep pounding a rhythm to the brain. La-di-da-di-dee, la-di-da-di-da. La-di-da-di-da. And the beat goes on and on and on. The beat goes on and on and on. The beat goes on and on and on. The beat goes on.
That was just so awesome. Thank you so much. But please, come on, let's hear it for Cher too. So, kid, can you feel the excitement? Do you feel the energy when we come out here?
Yes, I can.
It was awesome. It was spine tingling. It goes on and on and on. When does it all stop?
When you come out.
You know, Cher, I know you're just kidding. But I gotta say something. You sounded really awesome.
You sounded really adequate.
I was singing good. Wasn't I singing good? I was singing really good. But I have to say something. You stepped on one of my parts.
Yeah, that was the best part.
Okay, I know I was singing really good, you know? Tonight, I think Sonny Bono is gonna give the performance of his life. Yeah, tonight, everybody's gonna know that I'm here too, because let's face it, standing next to Cher, I look kind of ordinary.
Next to anybody, you look ordinary.
All right, listen. Talking about the way we look and the way things look. Here we are in the 21st century, 2015, and boy, do I have to say, you look dumb in that outfit.
Well, you don't exactly look like Brad Pitt either.
Folks, some of you may be wondering why we're dressed this way, and frankly, so are we.
Even in 1963 and 1964, people kind of wondered why we dressed this way.
Yeah, I made us dress like this in the 60s, but this is how we looked when we made our first record. Now, some of you may not know this, but before we made that first record, I was a record producer.
A record producer with no money.
Yeah, it's true, but still, a record producer nonetheless. And then I met Cher. Now, in order to actually make some money, we started singing background vocals on a bunch of songs. We went into the studio with Phil Spector and others, and we sang background on all of these great records. One of them, you may remember, it was a song by a band called The Crystals.
Hey kids, we're gonna take the last chorus, okay?
Okay.
Yes, my heart stood still. Yes, his name was Bill. And when he walked me home, they do run, 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 they do run, run.
And we sang for the Ronettes too. Thank you, thank you.
She said Ronettes too.
Sonny and Cher, can you take the vocal from bar 51?
Be my baby.
And the very last song we ever sang background on before becoming Sonny and Cher was this number one hit.
Sonny, can I get a level on the vocals for the two of you?
Can we hear the key?
Great, we're going.
Well, after recording on the Righteous Brothers record, Sonny wrote our first song, but it wasn't the one you thought it was.
Yeah, I wrote a song for Cher to sing, but we had a little problem. When we went into the studio to do the song, to record it, all of a sudden Cher went into the vocal booth and she was too shy to sing alone. Can you believe Cher? Too shy? So of course, I did the right thing, and I went into the vocal booth to sing it with her, and that's how Sonny and Cher came to be. And this was the song.
KMC cast at her own nightclub called Beethoven's way back in 1977. Since then, Bobby has become a Fort Lauderdale entertainment icon with his Bobby Rodriguez productions and being the sole producer and force behind the annual South Florida Renaissance Fair.
Rodriguez! Hey, everybody! Let's have some fun! You're only living once, and when you're dead, you're done. So let the good time grow. Let a good time roll. I don't care if you're young or old. Get together, let a good time roll. Now,
don't sit there mumbling, talking trash. You wanna have a problem, you gotta spend some cash and let the good times roll. Let them grow, let them grow. Barbie's in town. Got a dollar and a quarter and I'm ready to clown. Don't let nobody limit you. I got 50 cents more than I'm gonna keep. So let the good time roll.
By the way, that recording happened to be my orchestra. I'm very proud to have a 18-piece jazz big band that I've had the pleasure of singing in front of for over 35 years. Yeah. Thank you. And this next song, actually, 100 years ago this year, Frank Sinatra was born in Hoboken, New Jersey. And in honor of and memory of Mr. Sinatra, I decided to do some of his tunes on my latest album, and this is one of them that I recorded, and I'm sure most of you will recognize it. It's 2:45. There's no one in the place except you and me. So set him up, Joe. I got a little story I think you should know. We're drinking, my friend, to the end of a brief episode. So make it one for my baby. So make it one for and I got a lot of things I gotta say. And when I'm moving, please listen to me. I hope you didn't mind my bending your ears. But this corpse that I found, it's just gotta be drowned, or it soon might explode. So make it one for my baby, and one more for the road. Just make it one for my baby Joe. You know that it's a long, long, lonely road. So make it just one more for the
After many years performing her own Sally Ames show in Las Vegas, Lake Tahoe, and around the country, opening for acts like Frank Ocean, Bella Reese, Harry James, and singing on the Dinah Shore television show, our next performer came to us as part of a female trio spinoff of the KMC called The Red Rose Review. Please welcome Sally Schiff.
Good afternoon. Welcome.
All my troubles fill the limbo.
Rodriquez with the KMC, and I'm having a great time. I hope you all are. Good, good, good. And I have friends that came with me, and I thank you for coming with us this year for my husband Michael and I. Michael's doing the videotaping, so wave to the film. You might be on YouTube, but watch out. You never know what he puts on YouTube. Anyway, I'd like to take you back to the 1970s and reminisce with just a few of my favorites.
Never can say goodbye. No, 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 I never can say goodbye.
But we'll get to her later. He is a member of the Burt Reynolds Theater Group as a writer and actor. He is the phenomenal and exclusive KMC photographer, my best man, previous private eye, and former part-time Quaalude supplier. Weren't we all? You gotta love him. Together, they're performing a piece he wrote and directed entitled Early Bird Confessions. Ladies and gentlemen, Susie Cruz and Stephen Myrano.
You're on the other side.
Sorry.
Pardon me, but have you been to confession before?
Oh no, this is my first time.
Ah. Are you a Catholic?
Catholic? Are you kidding?
A Baptist then.
Oh my God, no. My mother would sit up in her grave.
Lutheran.
No, no.
Episcopalian.
No.
Latter-day.
No.
Seventh-day.
No.
Not that crazy actor thing.
Tom Cruise? No.
Then, what church are you from?
Temple Beth Am.
Temple Beth Am?
Temple Beth Am.
But, Temple Beth Am, that's a, and that would make you a
Jew. That would make me a Jew. Why, I've been a Jew for as long as I can remember.
Jew. Then you are in the wrong place.
Oh, but I would like to have my confession heard.
Then you should speak to your rabbi.
Oh, no, he doesn't hear confession.
I'm certain that he would counsel you.
No, I can't do that.
Why not?
Sheila.
Sheila? Who is Sheila?
Sheila, the rabbi's wife. Sheila, the blabbermouth is more like it. You must have seen her driving around town in that gaudy red convertible Mercedes. Oh, always wearing that low-cut top so everybody could see her big fake, for God's sakes. Her ex-husband was a plastic surgeon.
They were in the settlement.
I think I have seen her. but are you saying that the rabbi would share your personal information with his wife?
Is the Pope Polish?
No.
No?
No, the Pope is not Polish.
Really?
That was two popes ago. In fact, actually, the one after him, he retired.
Retired? He could retire now.
Was he too poop to poop?
Sorry. Where will we?
Sheila.
Oh, Sheila, yeah. When she doesn't hear from the rabbi himself, she hears through the wall of his office.
How do you know all this?
How do I know all this? I'm going to tell you how I know. There's this woman, Bernice Wasserman. She lives in my building, the Monte Excelsior.
Oh, the Monte.
Yes, her apartment is right below mine. Now, Bernice tells the rabbi that she thinks her husband, Bonnie, is cheating on her because he smells cheap perfume on his clothes when he comes home at night. Imagine that, cheap perfume, the goal of that woman. Don't cheat, the butler ain't cheap perfume, Bernice. You should try some. She tells him everything.
Everything?
Everything. How Bonnie doesn't take it anywhere anymore. How Bonnie doesn't get close to her anymore. How Bonnie doesn't think she's attractive. Well, not that woman ever looked attractive. The last time she wore makeup was at the Temple Halloween party. And get this. She tells the rabbi that she hired a detective to follow Bonnie. Can you believe it? A detective, for crying out loud. What's the matter? You can't have an innocent tattoo with a friend without hiring a detective, Bernice? What's this world coming to? And all this time in the other room, Sheila, that red Mercedes driving, memory enhanced, collagen filled blabbermouth, has got her big fat plastic surgery, pulled back ears, pressed up against that 90 pine wall paneling, listening to every word like Jan Behoover in a pair of specs.
How do you know all this?
How do I know all this? What's the difference how I know? I know! And you're gonna give me a hard time too? I thought they were paying you to listen!
Upset. I mean, I just got caught up in the story, is all.
Let's move on. You know, I should not have snapped at you. I mean, I have been a wreck all week. Just thinking how I was going to come here and free my soul.
Maybe we should move on, yes.
You know, I often wonder, you being a priest and all that, I bet you get to hear some pretty interesting confessions, if you know what I mean.
No, I don't know what you mean.
Oh, I mean unusual things. Funny things. Why, you could write a book.
Oh, no. I could never write a book. We have taken a vow never to reveal the names of our sinners.
Ah, the sinners. But not the sins. Come on, just one little sin, please.
Well, I have to admit, there have been some stories that have caused epic laughter at our dinner table.
Oh, go on, please tell me.
Well, I guess it wouldn't hurt. I mean, there is this woman that comes in every week, and she claims that she steals a jar of fish from the local fish market. I tell her she needs to stop because she's going to get arrested, but she keeps stealing the fish.
Gefilte fish.
What?
She steals a jar of gefilte fish. A little red-headed lady about 5 feet tall, hair teased up about a foot over her head.
That's her.
Yeah, Molly. Molly Zeitman. Yeah, she's the head of the banquet hall at our temple. And don't worry, she ain't gonna get arrested. She's in charge of all the bar mitzvahs, all the weddings. Do you have any idea how much fish Molly buys from Morty? He's making a killing off of her.
So he lets her steal the fish?
Of course he does. Look, it's perfect. He makes a living, she steals the fish, and you forgive her. Such a deal.
I guess.
What else you got?
This might be a little more interesting, but I think this person is making the story up, to be honest with you. It's a woman that comes in every few months, and she claims that she's poisoned her husband, and I...
Stop! Edna Moskowitz! About 5 feet four, digit-like hair, spiked up, looks like Elvira, with glasses bigger than her head!
That's her.
Don't worry, she ain't gonna kill him. You see, her husband, Mel, he's lactose intolerant, and every once in a while when he annoys her, she puts real milk in his bran flakes, binds him up with gas for days. You know, actually, I think she's punishing herself more than him. Could you imagine living with that? Well, looks like you got a bunch of Jews coming for confession. You ever get any Catholics in here?
Let's move on to Sheila.
Oh, Sheila. If she ain't driving that red Mercedes convertible, she's driving those Jews out of the temple faster than Pharaoh. But don't worry. It's good for your business. Oh my, look at the time. I gotta go.
But I haven't heard your confession.
Well, there was one little thing I kind of felt bad about.
Well, let's start there.
Well, no big deal. But last week, when I was leaving Morty's Fish Market, I kind of spaced the car next to me with my shopping cart. It was a very long, nasty scratch.
Oh, but that's not a sin. That's an accident.
It's not a sin?
Oh, no. That's not a sin.
Oh, I feel so relieved. Thank you, Father. Oh, my gosh. Did I mention it was a red Mercedes convertible? Have a nice day.
Good looks, great talent. Born in Rotterdam, Holland, Roy Michaels was a staple in what I call the KMC's master cast, touring with us for over 7 years. After the KMC, Roy went on to many great heights and honors, including becoming the lead singer for the world-famous recording act, The Brooklyn Bridge, after Johnny Maestro's passing. Still great, still crazy after all these years, ladies and gentlemen, Roy Michaels.
I'm Unfortunately, not everyone can have the best day of their life every day. As the poet said, into each life a little rain must fall. When you walk through a storm, hold your head up high and don't be afraid of the dark. At the end of the storm is a golden sky and the sweet silver song of a lark. Walk on through the wind, walk on through the rain, though your dreams be tossed and blown.
Oh,
Stop the music, stop the music. Sonny, where are you? I said stop the music, not shoot the drummer. Sonny, where are you?
I'm backstage here.
Well, come out here.
No.
What do you mean, no?
I look ridiculous. I don't want to come out.
Salvatore Philip Bono, get your little wampum out here. You're right. You do look ridiculous.
Thank you so much. Let me just tell you. You know what the problem is? Here's the problem, all right? When Cher gets a costume, the producer spends thousands and thousands of dollars. She gets all the best costumes. They spend all the money, and then I get this. Yeah, sure. You know, you always look good. Look at you. You always look good. She always looks good, right? You know, she always looks good. And you know, it's not that I don't like that she looks good. I love that she looks good. But you know what I really like? You know what I love? You know what I love? What she wears when she has like a long black dress on? You know, with like a slit up the side so you can see her long lean legs. And you got like a low cut neckline. It really accentuates your gorgeous shoulders and really draws attention to your sleek, firm, outstanding, size 38 nose! Nose, Cher! I got her again! I always get her! I get her! Zumba! I get her every time she walks right into it! Big nose, though. Nose! The Goomba does it again!
Don't you ever get tired of telling nose jokes?
You just don't know a good joke when you hear one.
No. But I know a good joke when I see one.
Don't encourage her, okay? That's not funny. That's really not funny. And I want to tell you something else, Cher. You know, I know you're part Cherokee Indian. And you look awesome in this wonderful costume with all the feathers and all the rhinestones and stuff. But you want to know something, Cher? You want to know something?
What?
That costume is not authentic.
Not authentic? What do you mean, not authentic?
Just what I said. It is not authentic. That's right. For your information, Cher, that's called a war bonnet. And only the Indian chief got to wear the war bonnet. That's right. And the chief, he's brave, and he's powerful, and he's the boss of the whole tribe, and he's always, always, Cher, a man. Yeah, the chief is always a man, Cher, not a woman. Now, if I got to wear that expensive outfit, then we'd have somebody up here that looks like an authentic Indian.
I think you look like a real Indian just the way you are.
You do?
Yes. In fact, I think you look like a very famous Indian.
Really? A famous Indian?
Yep. In that outfit, you look just like Tonto.
Tonto? Oh, the Lone Ranger's sidekick, Tonto!
You got it, Kimosabi.
I wonder what that means, Tonto. It must mean loyal, faithful companion. That would make me like Chief Bono.
No. Tonto is a Spanish word. And yes, ladies and gentlemen, if you've never heard this before, yes, you have to believe me, honest engine. Tonto is a Spanish word. And it means stupid.
Wait a minute, Sheik. That's stupid. No. Okay, but what does it mean in Cherokee?
It doesn't matter. You're stupid in any language. ladies and gentlemen, Tonto Bono. So let's cut him up and move him out, Tonto.
Rolling, 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 keep them doggies.
So due to some physical problems, and at the same time, I was in the hospital with my own problems. So I couldn't audition any new singers. Instead, our vocal director, Steve Cruz, also known as Sonny and Tonto, was in charge. Unbeknownst to me, Steve auditioned and subsequently hired a little girl named Susie Fierstein. And thank God he did. Susie was exactly what our show needed. And apparently, just what Steve Cruz needed too, because he changed her name from Susie Fierstein to who she is now introduced as, for all the shows across the country, Miss Susie Cruz.
Shows, it was when I saw the musical Chicago that I knew I was destined for the stage. Come on, babe, why don't we paint the town? In all that jazz, I'm gonna rouge my knees and roll my stacking down. In all that jazz, like butter, Miss Barbra Streisand! I guess I didn't make it. Get ready for me, love, for summer come. I simply gotta march my heart to summer. Don't bring around and lie to me no more. I'm afraid. I'm gonna live and live now. Take what I want. I know how. One cold road to pass. One cold out there will go back. I am the target. And there's one shot, one fine shot. And boom! At least it didn't fake it hot, sir. I guess it didn't make it. Yes, sir. I'm in love with my car. I think you got a word for how to go. But I don't know.
I needed a piano player, so auditions were held. In walks this neatly dressed, little red-haired, mild-mannered, super polite guy, obviously not a musician, and says, "Hi, I'm Steve Kaplan." I said, "Oh yeah, Steve Kaplan? Sit at this piano." And picking a song out of the clear blue sky, I said, "Do you know such and such a song, Steve Kaplan?" He said, "No, I've never played it, but I heard it once." I said, "Good, play it in the key of A." And so he did. I said, "Now switch to B flat, smarty pants." And so he did. "Oh yeah? Go to F sharp, D major, G, C, and E." And he did, and he did, and he did. I gave him the hardest audition ever, but he did it flawlessly. I asked him, "How long have you been playing piano?" He said, "Well, actually, my main instrument is guitar." Later, with the same flawless eye for perfection, Steve married an incredible songstress. Together, they now have one of the busiest corporate events entertainment companies in Florida. And so I give you Steve and Rhonda Kaplan.
Ooh, I love to rip the rain.
Joe Sadako wrote a song for another famous duo. It went something like this. All right. Once again, please welcome back to the stage, Sonny and Cher.
Sometimes when I'm down and all alone, I feel just like a child alone. The love you give me keeps me hanging on, honey. All I ever need is you. Rainbows, I am told. some men search for silver, some for gold. But I have found my treasures in your nose, honey. All I ever need is you. All I ever need is you.
Thank you so much. I know. We look good now, huh? Yeah. No more of that Indian stuff, right? Not that there's anything wrong with that. But you know, I gotta say, you really look good, kid.
Aw, thanks.
My fair share.
My funny Sonny.
Fair share. A wonderful singer, I suppose. I would be too if I had that nose.
Funny Sonny, a wonderful sport. I would be too if I was that short.
All right, okay. Listen, you're not gonna get to me now, because you know what? I look good, huh? I look good, and because I look good, I feel pretty good too. Now, because of that, because I feel so good, I've got a big surprise for you, and for all of you folks out there too. I got a huge surprise. I have been given a huge honor, and Cher don't know nothing about it. She's never gonna guess in a million. You're never gonna guess, not in 100,000 gazillion years are you ever gonna guess. Go ahead, guess. I want you to guess, please. Don't go ahead and try to guess. I dare you.
Go ahead, surprise me.
I knew you couldn't. Folks, I have been asked to pose for a nude centerfold. What, Cher? And guess which magazine?
Ripley's Believe It or Not.
Come on, Cher. You know this magazine. It's first Burt Reynolds, and now me.
Next month, Daffy Duck.
All right. Now you're just being jealous, you know? Because you know, when my picture comes out, millions of women are going to see me, and it's going to kill them.
Yeah, they're going to die laughing.
Listen. When my picture comes out, Cher,
yeah,
I'm going to become a sex symbol. S-E-X. Symbol. Sex symbol, Cher. Yeah, that's right. How would you like to be married to a sex symbol?
Well, that would be terrific, but I miss you now and then.
Don't encourage it, please. You gotta make your jokes. Go ahead and make your jokes, you know? But I know for a fact, Cher, that this body is gonna do wonders for that magazine circulation.
Well, I sure hope so, because it's not doing very much for mine. Now, come on, sex symbol, let's go. You may miss your photo shoot that way.
About 3 months ago, somebody said, the incredible Johnny L., who used to work with you at Beethoven's, is back in town. I said, who? They said, the incredible Johnny L. He says he worked with you at Beethoven's. I said, nah, nobody named Johnny L. ever worked with me at Beethoven's. Then they told me he's singing with Roy Michaels tonight, and they told me I should go see who they're talking about. I said, you're darn right I'm going. And I went to see him at Roy's show. The moment I saw John's face, I remembered, yes! I auditioned and hired John on the same day that I left Beethoven's, so I never actually saw him perform in the Beethoven show. But I did see him perform at Roy's show that night, and let me tell you, folks, you're in for a real treat. Ladies and gentlemen, the incredible Johnny L.
I just did it alone, and everywhere I go, people know the parts I'm playing. I paid for every dance, sell each romance. There will come a day when youth will pass away. Oh no, what will they say about me? When the end comes, I know I'll be just a gigolo. Life goes on without me.
who used to manage, teach, and terrorize several show bands in the early and mid-70s. Among those show bands was Rainy Days, from which several early KMC members were snatched, and another band named Johnny D and the Fifth Celebration. One of the featured performers in that show was a young singer with an unbelievably high tenor voice, and, as I remembered, he could tap dance too. After I left Beethoven's, the new musical director was looking for a tap dancing tenor. What a coincidence! Joey Kennedy joined the Beethoven Show and later starred in another KMC production on Fort Lauderdale Beach. Since then, he has become one of the best known and loved entertainers in all of South Florida history. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Joey Kennedy. Thank you. No tap dancing today. This one by Frankie Lyman.
So you met someone who set you back on your heels. Goody, goody. So you met someone, now you know how it feels. Goody, goody. But you gave them your heart too, just to sign your mind to you. And you broke it in little pieces. How do you do? So you lie awake, singing the blues all night.
Next song I'd like to do is by this group comes from Long Island. Anybody from Long Island? No. 2, 3, 5. Well, still okay. Thanks. They're great band. I'm dedicating this to my wife Lori, whose favorite band is this band. They were called the Rascals, the Young Rascals. How can I be sure? In a world that's constantly changing, how can I be sure where I stand with you? Whenever I'm away from you, I don't know why. Maybe you're trying.
just hanging around with my head up, upside down. It's a pity I can't seem to find someone who's as pretty and lovely as you. How can I be sure?
I'd like to bring out a good, really good friend of mine. Beautiful guy. He's just sang just a little while ago. His name is Johnny L. And we're going to do a little opera tune for you. This is by, there he is, Andrea Bocelli. Nice tux, man. Are you on? We need the mic on again.
Solo, solo, soy el horizonte, manca de parole. Si lo so que luce, luce una stanza cuando manca el sole. Se noche se tu con me su le finestre mostra tutto il mio cuore che hai acceso. Chiudi dentro me la luce che hai incontrato per strada. Oh,
ladies and gentlemen, would you welcome back for the last time this evening, Sonny and Cher.
So much. Have you guys had as much fun tonight as we've had? Please, if you would, let's just all together give a nice round of applause for all of these amazing entertainers tonight. Hey. Now, in addition, I do want to take just a moment, please, because, you know, all night long, Cher makes fun of me, I make fun of Cher, you know, it's all in good fun, but I wanted to take a serious moment, because this is my partner for life, my best friend. Our careers are totally intertwined, so I wanted just a serious moment, if you would, a moment of recognition, please, for Cher's nose, come on! Nose.
Will you stop with the nose jokes already? Stop. Once again, folks, we're really glad you joined us this evening, and we really hope you had a great time, because we did. But we wouldn't leave you without doing this one.
Chance to rehearse this, so right. Whatever happened today, so we